It's been a bit, hasn't it? I'm here, back with the seat of the week, finally, after probably a few months of not playing Free Enterprise at all. This one looks kind of like the Swiss rounds, except a little light. Only four objectives. Okay, Summon and Moon. The pass is in the key item pool. But we do get Treasure Wild, which is going to be good for me, because I usually lean towards treasure checking rather than shop checking. Yeah. We're going to do it. Let's roll. Let's see what I can do. It's been a bit. Eddie start. Not ideal. Ooh. Almost forgot. Gotta remind myself that the spoon flag is on. No, just kidding. We'll just keep her Rosa. The O and the Zero are indistinguishable, so doesn't matter. I have to name these two. I can't distinguish the two of them. It's just for some reason a blank spot in my skill set / memory. Oh, and Rosa. That's a really hard start for me. With Crystal, though. Okay. I don't have an objective tracker. I'm gonna have to either remember or use the one in the game. That sucks. I didn't think about that, actually. I haven't played any random objective seeds, now that I think about it. I'm used to having the commentary tracker in front of me. What a seed of the week. Eddie and Rosa start with moon objectives. Okay. I'm gonna do this the old-fashioned way then. Let's see what I can find. I need a bow pretty badly with this start. Sure is useful. if I get rid of, you know, my, my timer didn't start, actually, now that, for some reason. What's going on here? Live split? What are you doing? Okay. Why are you not working? It's gone crazy. Okay. Cool. Well, I'm gonna let that run. I don't know exactly how long the seed's actually been going. Just displaying the objectives takes about 30 seconds. Or is it better that I restart it? But then I have knowledge of the objectives. I'll guesstimate a minute and I'll watch it back and see how much it is before I put my time in. The seed of the week ends tomorrow, so I'll call it at a minute and just go after that. Stuff, but not the nice stuff that's gonna let me get that Hobbs character, unless it's a really easy boss. I'm gonna have to check, break down and check Baron. I usually don't check Baron. It's kind of a gamble that I just always do. Sid, that'll help a lot if I can get him. There's a Moon Veil. Okay, well maybe I can cheese my way through his first fight. We'll see who's at Hobbs. If I can't get him, then I gotta either item hunt more or cheese something. Characters are not guaranteed on this flag set either, so let's see. Okay, so Ashura is now immediately more useful. Dark Imp here. Dark Elf, I don't know. I just don't know. I didn't find any bows for Rosa, so this is not gonna work, I don't think, actually. Treasure's helping me out. that after I saved as well. If I wipe, I'll have to redo it. That'll get me through. Alright, well, I don't want to waste time, so I'm still going to try this boss, but let's get some of those up. I should definitely... Oh, I can Moon Veil her if I have to, and then... Ooh, Dark Knight Cecil. Okay. Well, that's not too awful. I should be actually good at that. Justice is not the only way it right in this world. Someday you will see. The Pain Manifesto. Okay, I like that. I like that. Do I have any exits? I clicked out the window. No. That's unfortunate. But I needed those levels and this treasure, so I can't call it a loss. I really don't like mage parties either, but that's what it looks like they're stacking up to be. We'll see who the package character is. I did see Cid and Baron Inn, so it's not all doom and gloom. Oh, it's Edward. That's a shame. Who rolled this seed? Oh my gosh. Did I save it after I came out? Please say I did. Okay. Ooh. Let's see what's inside the shop for me, maybe. Just go for Hobbs again. And do better this time. Maybe use that Moon Veil and just cheese with Rosa. Good fun. of this, since the treasure is what I'm needing right now. I'm getting all sorts of armor and weapons for characters I don't have. It's not great. Not a fan. I've had Earth Crystal this whole time, haven't I? Yeah, I could have looted the armory. And I didn't even think about it. The ice from the other side. Titan, okay. I'll take that for sure. For sure. Okay. So we gotta do the armory, probably hit Fogu just for some levels, and then try Baron in to get Sid, stack all this equipment on somebody. Remember that those are there, but I'm not gonna buy any right now. Stuff. Where's Cecil? No protector. Wow. I'm like stacked. There's some silence. Ooh, two. Okay. It's good to know when I get underground. Right now. Sirens are probably somewhere in shops too. I haven't really done my shop checks.
for right now.
Hope we find a spoon for Edward at some point. And I feel like I've done nothing. That just shows how rusty I am, really. I've been doing behind the scenes stuff instead of playing, and it definitely shows. Alright, now time to get Sid. We need some heavy hitting action here. Bahamut. The low HP spot, that's fine. Oh, it's Leviathan. Whoops. I always mess that up. I don't wanna kill him. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. The next battle's gonna be the hard one. Edward should be killing him. How am I gonna get rid of like 3,000 HP on this next battle though? I'm gonna hope it's an easy one. Ooh, Luge! Okay. There we go. Thank you. We should be waking up soon. I forget how long it lasts. Beam doesn't wake him up because it's a magic attack. I just need like one or two Everett attacks and I will get him. That damage by poison message is really like they could do it without it. They have the HP sap that sends the message without it. Now we have Cid and we can deck him out right away. No. Objective complete, though. There's three more. I need the twin harp. I need to go to the moon. There's poison access in Typo. Don't get one of those. Really the only weapon shop I went into, actually, but that'll do for now. Definitely hard-hitting enough. Now I gotta try ordeals, right? Before I try that hook, for sure. I don't have the damage to get through the hook spot yet, I don't think. Unless it happens to be a dragon, I use those last seven hardness arrows. Let's look at the city. Oh, I guess I could do Earth Crystal. Now that I think about it. Two characters. I'll do ordeals first. I'm right here anyways. Should probably do something. No. Let's just do this. I'm already here. And there's treasure. Because I sold those two Excaliburs, I can really buy some ridiculous equipment. If I need it. At least the Earth Elemental. Actually, that's not gonna work, is it? Well, never mind. I guess it works. His next form is the one. This dancing dagger is actually coming quite handy, isn't it? McKee, yes, it's not a hook seed. Bro, I am gonna pick up the adamant armor before I go underground though. I could look at the character in Evelyn Cave too. If I have a Bacchus, I technically have the tools I need. I really want a Caesar though. So I think I am gonna get the Hovercraft. I'm gonna turn in the pink tail. I'm gonna check the Evelyn Cave character and then I'm gonna dive Magma Key. I know that seems like a lot, but it's should probably doesn't make sense to check Earth Crystal now. It's two characters. Then I might not need to check the hook character because I might have who I want. Let's look. let's get that adamant armor first. Sid or Rosa? Probably Sid for now. That will change. Welcome, Paramabara. No, it's actually a randomizer. Based on Final Fantasy IV. It's called Free Enterprise. You start with the airship, all the boss, and key item locations are randomized. Also, all the treasure. Yes, everyone, I know that's not actually the fastest way to go to the cave, but I didn't do my Silvera item check yet, so let's get a twofer here. I'm just looking for... Don't mind if I do. Well, I guess I'm keeping Rydia now. Ashura and Sylph. Backup white mage now. I keep on getting stuff. I don't really. There's another dancing dagger. Oh no. Get out of my way, frog. Okay, well, that was a bust, but the admin armor is gonna make up for that time loss. I'm gonna kind of YOLO this one. I'm not gonna save before the Magus Sister spot because I just wanna... This is actually a bad play, what I'm doing, so I need to make it as fast as possible. I probably won't check any of the treasure here either because I'm pretty much actually set on everything except maybe like some more Artemis arrows for Rosa. I would like something better for Sid, but I don't need something better for Sid. Of course, if I get a Cecil or a Kane, I have all the equipment I need for them, so... Defense Sword is the only thing I'd be still looking for. It's not an opening chest for it, so... I basically need to be done opening chests right now. Yeah, my accessories are good. Like, I don't have good armor for anybody, but the accessories kind of make up for it. YOLO, let's see who this boss is. Hopefully it's not one that's gonna kill me. Okay. Baron Guards. I like that. I like that. I like that. Ooh, here comes the piggies. That last one, have a coffin too, so I don't know why. I only have one left. He is conscious now. Why does that not work? I'm very confused. Did I miss? I'm actually so confused now. The heal didn't work. Oh, he's dead, that's why. Wow, what the heck am I doing? This one should actually be dead from HP loss here pretty soon. I can't believe I wasted that coffin on him, but I didn't really have a choice. There's Pursuit. That's what I needed. Okay, I'm gonna save after that. I'm a berserk strat for Zeromus guy myself. I don't like reflex strats, so seeing Eddie here is real nice. And by Eddie, I mean Edge, because his name is also Edward. Okay, this paid off big time. This paid off big time. Okay, so that means Edward is gone. Dancing dagger on him. I don't care about that. Yeah, that's good. I don't really care. I don't actually really care what equipment he has. Actually, so, okay, it's gonna be adamant for sure. Okay. Let's go. Got stone as well. No quake yet, but give it time. No quake or nuke, but I got medium. I got everything I need. Get someone to replace Rydia with later and just roll with this. Honestly, I didn't look and see what spell that was. Alright, so now I really need to get moving. I can do all the checks I want except for probably Fey March bosses. Yeah. I'm gonna have to fight a bunch of moon bosses anyway, so I probably don't have to grind that much either. I only found two sirens and didn't find them in stores yet. There's a pan. Yes. Double dip that sylph cave. You betcha. Okay. Straight to Agard then. Rest in peace, whoever was the Evelyn Cave character, because I am not doing that now. We will give this some look just in case. I don't think... Really, I'm just looking for cabins from these shops now. Actually, my potions could be good. Just in case. I didn't drop the key. This is going swell. Check the bosses in Feymarch. This was my favorite dungeon theme when I was a kid. It's so peaceful. I love it. Not bad. Not awful. That's just step one. Two more items for that, so... Shop could be useful. That's the only use for it now. I see. I still got cannons. Oh baby, that's it. It seems over. This seed is over. I have Foo, I have Sirens, it's over. If I can't take these bosses, I'll go out Siren, check Sheila, and then just cream everything. Actually, maybe doable. Odin, I don't think is doable for me yet. Doesn't have finish yet. That was not a good start. We'll just come back later. Sheila. Okay. And Legend Sword. Okay. Kokul's shop open. Get another X-Cal. Should just go and use these sirens as well. To be frank though, I'm still hoping for one more character. I'm looking to replace Rydia. It would be nice to get another physical attacker right here. Kane or Cecil would be good with either one. Hopefully Cecil though. He would be real nice to see here. A shame if somebody used Titan on you. I didn't have to do that, I have virus. So I get the full use view. Targets aren't there, so can't get Titan. I didn't save before I came in at all. I should say I didn't save in the dungeon, I didn't save after Calcabrana. Of course it gets free. He is super slow at this spot though, so I'm probably gonna be okay. Alright, I guess I'd rather see him here than somewhere else, right? Blink, that's what I actually needed. Ooh, there's Quake and Berserk. Cecil, come on! Oh, it's another Rydia. Nope. I do like that Rydia color palette. It's the first time I've seen that. I love it. But she has got to go. Okay, I'm just not getting the character then. I'm just gonna do my thing. We'll just have to level a little bit harder to get Edge into safe HP territory. That's it. He does have an adamant on, but against Aramis, that's not as helpful. Rat tail. Okay. Okay, so I kind of got a 2 for there. I have 10 key items already. This is looking actually pretty good. Oops. I still need to find a twin harp. To fight those boss rooms on the moon side of the darkness as well. I should just go do sirens before I come down here and check this, but I'm already here, so it feels dumb to do that. It might be the smart play though. Evil wall. This could be bad. Not too bad, as long as I can get these berserks off. I feel good about this. Oof. What the heck was that? I didn't get armor on too. Those high roll attacks are. Yikes. Did not get the berserk off. Let's come back in a minute. I have 10 key items, I have sirens, so I have no reason not to do it now. Just blow through everything from here on out, the rest of the seed. There we go. There's virus on radio, so we good. It was useful again, and I didn't even have to do Dwarf Castle. Take two casts, I may as well just use Fatal. Rat tail. We'll go check Odin. Hope that what we need is there and I don't have to fight those bosses in Feymarch. That'd be annoying. Because with these moon bosses I have to fight. Hopefully. Stoneheart is on the moon since I have to go there anyways. Alright, we're off to the moon then. I will still check the Odin spot, just in case, since I'm already up here. And after that, it is straight to the moon. Probably fight all the bosses in the lunar subterranean. It's not what I wanted, but it's good. Now he can really deal the berserk damage. Go to the moon. Hopefully it's not buried in those Fame Arch bosses. I have four spots that I can access on the planet that it could be in, but I've got six spots that it could be in on the moon, so. Checking the moon shop. I'm still looking for some Bacchus wine. I'm gonna have to come back to Earth at some point anyways because I don't have Cave Magus. Magus. Thank you. it's okay. I feel like I'm so slow here. I don't even know what it's gonna be when I turn this time in. I'm gonna be down at the bottom for sure. Who's this? Really, I can't, unless it's Cecil, then I can't really afford to take whoever it is anyways. No. Goodbye. Sorry, Baka. Let's go. I'm still item hunting, so I'm gonna do all the boss locations. And even though I know it's not the right play, I still go top down. It's just the way I do it. I gotta de-rust here because you have to know your way around a lunar subterranean. I just wasted 20 seconds walking the wrong way to a trap chest that I don't need and I'm not gonna open. Well, it might not have been trapped, but in the originally, it's definitely trapped. We're not doing that one. I don't feel like messing, fiddling with it. That's not it. This is what we call gambling. Took me forever to find this as a kid. I got to this point in the game so many times, and the battery was bad on my grandmother's copy of this game. So I got to this point many times, and then I'd come back, you know, like a month or two later when she was watching me again, and my progress would be gone. I'd get back to this dungeon again. My bad. spot, so I should only have to survive with one. Up the lit one before he even queued up the wave. Yes. He still managed to get the wave off. I queued up the lit one before he even gathered the water. He still managed to wave me. I don't understand how that's the case. That's crazy, guys. That's... it up beforehand and he still does it. Of course he's gonna do it if I queued up afterwards. I think I'm dead. Didn't heal enough. Yeah. Edge might live. Everybody will. Wow. Should be good. Edge can handle it from the rest of it, so. There we go. Alright, well, Sid missed that, but he doesn't actually need the XP anymore, really, anyways, so. There's Quake. Full power foo. To see. Okay, so that got one of my objectives. I don't think I have a cabin. I don't. Cabins, but I have like 6 more either, 5 more either, 2 I think. Hopefully enough to get me through the last 3 boss fights. I gotta kind of gamble here and go for the 2-for. Excellent. Okay. Well, I have Starbase, so. I already fought Golden, so I have no reason to hoard them. I should have berserked them before I did that. So, I guess maybe not. Enough moves. Should actually be dead pretty soon. He's These bots don't have as much HP as you would think they would for end-game bosses. That was a miscalculation. So it was for. Okay, we all still have wall now. But we have wall. When exactly was it running? Right at like the wrong time too. Okay, so mine is running out. He's just got a rebound. So he should be able to deal with this. That's a push. So for some it's still safe. Not great, buddy. I've had to nope out of a lot of stuff that I shouldn't have, and it's not great. I'm actually almost done checking the moon, though, so that is something. I have one more check on the moon, except for the one at the top, which is Wyvern. So I think I'm gonna kind of gamble that that's not what it is, and try to. Just try to go back to Earth, use the items that I found up here, because all I need now is a twin harp, and I can complete the final objective. So I'm really just looking for one key item. once I go back to the planet, I can use the key items that I found up here and also beat some bosses that I did not have the stones to try earlier. Now that I've got some levels on me. Oh no. Okay, if it's this, I'm just gonna forfeit. That's the Moon Gauntlet in the Crystal Palace spot. Fight on evil masks and all sorts of crazy crap. I'm not doing that. If it's that, I lose. That's all there is to it. I'll forfeit straight up. I'm not fighting the Moon Gauntlet. Yeah, you know, I feel the same way about Link to the Past randomizer. I don't play Link to the Past. I've played it, but I've never speedran it. I've never even played the randomizer for it, but it is a very entertaining watch for sure. Super Metroid randomizer, same thing. I love it. It's just, I myself am not good enough at Super Metroid, even though it's one of the games I absolutely love. I'm not good enough at it to play the randomizer, I feel like. Alright, so now it's time. I can go check all the underground spots. I could have checked Bahamut's spot as well, but I forgot. You know, I am mostly a speedrunning spectator and have been since probably like 2005 or 2006. I only speedrun one game that I actually have submitted a time for, and that is Loom. So I like to work behind the scenes for a lot of stuff though. Like, I do commentary and tracking for this randomizer community. I do like volunteering stuff at GDQ and RPG on the break. Alright, this is a 2-fer, so let's go. I do actually have it on my list. I want to learn Super Mario Land for the Game Boy this year. That is one that is on my learn list for sure. And then probably, I'm in the Cuso Grande tournament right now. Cuso Grande, however you say it. I got third place in my match today, so I need to get first or second in my next match in order to progress. But if I see a good bad game in there, then I will definitely probably pick it up, because they're usually short as well. Great place for CPU. Oh yeah, I mean, there's nothing like watching like a good Super Mario Brothers 1 or 3 speedrun where you're just like, oh my god, it's absolutely nuts. Ooh, yeah. A lot of those classic Super Nintendo games, which are just like Super Mario World, all that jazz. There's a reason why there's some of the most speedrun games. Because they're good. People like watching them too, which helps people, you know. It's hard to keep running a game if you're never getting any viewers, you're never getting any chatters. So, I mean, playing a popular game just makes sense. It's why people, partially why people gravitate towards them, besides the fact that they love the game, of course. Up here. Gosh. It's the other Mylon. Poor Water Hag? I think this is one of those screens where the color palette gets messed up. I just wasted an Artemis arrow on Water Hag. It's okay. I'm not going to use her for very much anymore. I I already ditched Spoon. Sorry, Anna. Arrgh. Heck, even Rydia's almost Big Bang ready. There's the Twin Harp. I didn't have to do the cannon room. This is why people don't do the cannon room first. Okay, so the moon was not a waste of time for me, because I did get the tower key. Well, no, it was a waste of time. Because I could have done this before I even went up there. That's okay. I still haven't found Bacchus wands. I guess I will check Dwarf Castle at least for those. Oh yeah. The Super Nintendo overall has some of the best soundtracks ever. Not just of retro games, but ever. This game was the first game that made me realize, like, video games could have absolutely amazing music, and not just music that sounded like a video game, but music that could, you know, potentially stand on its own. This, actually the special soundtrack for this game, Celtic Moon, is the first arranged soundtrack I ever bought. Oh man, yeah, this Aromas fight music is a banger, dude. Banger. It's so good. Oh yeah, it's great. Stardust Rod, okay. Cool, alright, let's check Dwarf Castle for Bacchus Wine. This is the last spot it could be. Because I'm pretty sure on S Standard it cannot be in Overworld Shops. I didn't check all of them. Here. I think my edge can survive some Big Bangs, hopefully you can. No Bacchus wines. That's unfortunate, but I do have foo, so I can do double berserks. It's fine. Everything's fine. Rydia's gonna die, but that's okay. So we need to shift some stuff around here then. So you need to take that off. Because you're about to take a dirt nap. Give him that. Oops. Take the protector and it's fine. Gosh, is it worth checking Coco Shop for Bacchus Wines? I have the necessary items. I guess. My time's already screwed, so I'll just check it. Who cares? Excalibur, let's play through. I sold the other two because I had a crystal sword, but I never found Cecil, so. Come on. Okay, well, I'll take that. Elf real quick, and we'll be getting our crystal going into Zeromas. I don't have the pass though, so I am gonna have to walk all the way down. Unfortunately, this time is gonna be totally wrecked, but what can you do? There will always be people who 17 out of 17, and so at least I'll beat the people that got unlucky, basically. Whoop. At least harp was required on the seat of the week, so I know everybody got to hear the music. Oh, I forgot that they released Final Fantasy VII for the Switch, actually. I'm honestly just waiting for the remake and then remembering that the remake is only the first third of the game, so... But Final Fantasy VII is a game that I've replayed really a ton. I don't really... it's weird to say as I'm playing a randomizer, which is, you know, a complete waste of time. Not waste of time, but, like, not a new game. But I really don't have time to replay long games like Final Fantasy VII anymore. That used to be one I replayed every single year, along with Final Fantasy X. FF8 was like in every other year. FF9 was an every year thing. But now, I mean, the idea that I could replay Final Fantasy VII, I would get way too deep on my... on my new games to playlist, basically. Yeah, see, back in the day, I skipped 6 when it came out, so I played 6 after I played 7, which is a kind of a weird way to experience the series, I think. You do see how much Final Fantasy VII borrowed from 6, though, if you really think about it and sit down and look at it. Ghost Moon. Like, even the environmentalist message is kind of similar. Oh, yeah. Kefka's a better villain than Sephiroth, because... Ooh. Aw. I don't really have a problem with Sephiroth. They tried to flesh him out more in all the compendium of Final Fantasy VII games to be more of his own thing. But if you think about it, like, 95% of the game, you're not fighting Sephiroth, you're not seeing Sephiroth, that's all Jenova. So, like, actual Sephiroth being a villain is really like a last second thing. Oh, Eddie. Too low level now, Eddie. Now that I got it. I actually didn't realize you actually have to grab that item in order to, for that objective to flag, so good thing I learned that now rather than in a race. Yeah, I mean, they have a habit of it, but to say that Sephiroth is some cool villain when actually you're not really seeing him, the game kind of does a bait and switch on you. And I think a lot of people who played FF7 back in the day, for a lot of reasons, some involving the translation, didn't really know, like, that was what was going on, so. Square in that time period definitely did like to pull out the enemies at the last instant on you. Like, even Ultimicia wasn't... I mean, she was hinted at much earlier. Or maybe you were supposed to think Adele was the one, but... You know. Or Necron. I mean, Necron in Final Fantasy IX, what's going on there? Especially since they could have just used Garland. Like, we know in Final Fantasy IX that Garland did not die when... he didn't die when Kefka, or Kuja, threw him off that cliff. They should have just used him as the final boss. Don't get me wrong, Necron is stylish, but doesn't make a whole lot of sense. FF10 now. They kind of did the same thing, but Yu Yevon was pretty widely foreshadowed, I think. It was good enough for me. But still, the second to last boss is still like Sin slash Jax, and that's who you knew you were going to be fighting the whole game, so. Never played Final Fantasy X. Wow. It's a classic. You should. It's good. XII is okay. I like the characters. The story needs a little bit of work because it's so most of the events that happen aren't due to your character's actions, which I think is a problem with the narrative. And then, of course, there's all the well-known problems with Final Fantasy XIII and its sequels. I was actually someone who liked Final Fantasy XIII, so for me, it's not that bad. XV, I wasn't a fan of. I played it once, and that was it. I didn't play any of the add-ons. It had big-time storytelling problems because Nomura doesn't have anybody at the company anymore who will tell him no, and he just keeps adding bloat, like both gameplay bloat and story bloat to everything. And then he adds so much story bloat that he can't fit it, all the story in the game. He has to put it in other stuff, but when I play a game, I don't want to have to watch like the two spin-off movies to even understand what's happening in the game. Interesting. The auto mod flagged the word FF8 as profanity in your post, which it clearly is not. It's odd. And the GFs lose their shine once you really figure out the junction system, though. Oh, you know what? I didn't check my agility before I came in here. Oh well, it's Fusoya, so it can't be too far off. I've got HP to deal with, whatever, hopefully. Get that Cure 4 out. Ooh, but that sick hit from Edge. Like that. With two white mages, I should be fine. We'll see what who heals up, and then we'll see if I need to throw one of those into it. Already shaking. He's actually gonna big bang it again. If I'm not careful. Yeah. Dang. Hopefully it's a low roll. Or else my white mages are done for already. Oop. This is not great. Here comes the black hole already. This is how not checking your agility can really screw you in this fight. I'm actually lucky he black holed because it means I can 2-4 in time before the next one. Sid might even be down, honestly. This is a wreck of a fight. God, we both died. Not great. I'm honestly probably should just reset this. And do it with the right. The right stuff. Shaking already, dang. Not good. The next turn needs to be Rosa. And she get it off in time. Nope. Hopefully it's a good level. Damage on him too here. He's so fast. Here we go. There we go. Everybody back up to full. Well, not Sid, but maybe enough. Hopefully enough on Sid to work. I should have healed him, self-healed with an item. I got greedy. As long as I keep Edge alive, like those sick 4000s or whatever, it's what I need. I think I phase changed, actually. Yeah, I did. Because he shook and then he shook again. I really just want him berserked to clog up the ATVQ. I don't really need him for the damage. Hopefully he lives his big man. That would be nice. And hopefully I don't get a black hole. Yes, he lived. Good. She's got plenty of MP to outlast. I think I should need to start throwing nukes with Fu, to be honest. Well, first I need to re-up my berserk here because I never found Bacchus Horns. Oh, oh. Oh yeah? Exactly zero MP. Ooh, direct nuke. I actually like that. And now, Fu goes down. I think I'm gonna leave him down. Oh, meteor face. Never mind. Missed everybody except Sid, too. That's good. Yeah, we done. Oh. And for some reason my timer doesn't stop sometimes. I don't know why. It's really annoying. It only happens in free enterprise, not when I'm actually speedrunning the splits. But let's see where that puts me on the leaderboard. It can't be good. This was the seed of the week, so let's do it. Oh wait, what? It actually puts me 8th. That's actually very surprising. I would not expect to have gotten that. And there's a lot of people that are within 5 minutes of me, so really, if I had been 15 minutes faster, I could have been 3rd on this seed. Yeah, I guess so. Maybe they checked the places that I skipped. That could be. But, yeah, the fastest time was 1 hour and 27 minutes. Now I actually don't feel that bad, because I'm not that far off. I'm only 20 minutes off that. That's not bad at all. I actually feel pretty good now. Awesome. Well, so, it pays to not forfeit Seeds of the Week. You gotta at least see what everybody else did. Cool. Well, I'm off to the spoiler channel. Thanks for joining me, Vince. It was good conversation. And, you know, maybe I'll catch a future stream. I don't know. I do a lot of this. I actually need to start de-rusting Loom because I have it in some online marathons. So, tune in later. Thank you.